I'm Tech Adams. Welcome to my laboratories, where we explore science through technology and technology through science. Today, we're going to be looking at what's probably the most important question in all of science and technology. Is a Mac a PC? If you get all of your information on the subject from television commercials, it's really easy to answer this question with a resounding no. The Mac is not a PC, obviously. The Mac is young and hip, while the PC is old and nerdy, obviously. The word PC is a synonym for Windows, right? In technology, the acronym PC stands for personal computer, a subclassification of computer whose price, power, and size are small enough that it can be purchased for and used by only one person. Unlike supercomputers, mainframes, minicomputers, and servers, which are meant to be bought by companies to serve a greater number of users with more power, but at a higher cost. The PC category includes all desktops, laptops, notebooks, netbooks, ultrabooks, and tablets, regardless of the manufacturer or operating system. In the broadest sense of the term, it can also include things like cell phones and calculators, modern televisions, DVD players, digital cameras, and so on, though these things are usually excluded from the category because they're built for a more specific purpose rather than for general computing. Under this definition, nearly every computer that Apple has ever produced, and certainly the entire Mac lineup, are in fact PCs. But there's another definition of the word PC, one that grew out of the early 1980s and became popular in computer culture, that may explain the real difference between a Mac and a PC. But in order to understand this, we're going to have to look at a little bit of techno history. At the heart of all computers is a microprocessor called the CPU. The CPU is an all-in-one chip that handles the main functions of a device, like the chip that handles addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division in a calculator. In 1978, Intel released a groundbreaking microprocessor, the Intel 8086. What set the 8086 apart from all other microchips on the market was that it wasn't purpose-built to run a specific piece of technology like a calculator. Instead, it was designed to accept commands from programs for what's called general computing, using a specific set of predefined instructions to accomplish any task. The set of commands that the chip accepted for its general computing was named x86. A year after releasing the 8086, Intel released the 8088 chip that used the same x86 instruction set, but was a little less powerful, so that it would cost less to build a full computer. In a rush to enter the personal computer market, computer manufacturer IBM released the IBM PC in 1981, using readily available parts and processors instead of its own, including the Intel 8088 as the central processing unit. While it was not the first PC on the market, it did have something that only mainframes and minicomputers had at the time, an operating system. An operating system sits between a computer's physical hardware and its programs, creating a standardized environment in which the programs can run. This makes the programs less dependent on exactly what brand and model of chip are inside the computer, simplifying how programs are written and standardizing the user experience. Of course, in their haste to get a product to market, IBM hadn't actually made their own operating system. Rather, they used one that was designed by another company, and then purchased and modified by a third company to meet IBM's specifications. Which company did the modifications? One you've probably heard of, Microsoft. And the operating system? MS-DOS version 1.0. To get DOS on their personal computers, other companies including Dell and HP quickly copied IBM's PC system using the same third-party chips, including the Intel 8088. These systems were said to be IBM compatible, or compatible with IBM's operating system. Naturally, they were quickly nicknamed IBM PC clones, later shortened to just PC clones, and finally, as simply as it was at first, just plain old PCs. As a result of DOS and the PC clones, the x86 general computing command set became the most common for personal computers. Extended versions have formed the de facto standard for most general computing processors ever since, including the Intel 80x86, Pentium, Celeron, Xeon, Core 2, and Core I series of processors, AMD's K, Athlon, Phenom, Duron, Optron, and A series processors, just to name a few. Essentially, PC clones are everywhere. But what about Apple computers? They're personal computers for sure, but they're not PC clones. Rather than using the Intel x86-based chips, early Apple computers used more process-specific Motorola chips. In 1991, Apple teamed up with Motorola and IBM to create a new general-purpose processor, the PowerPC. By partnering in the design of the microprocessor, Apple was able to better integrate its proprietary operating system and software with the hardware, making its Macintosh computers run distinctly differently than the x86-based PC clones. Hence, a Mac versus a PC. In 2006, Apple started a very successful advertising campaign called Get a Mac, which featured characters introducing themselves as I'm a Mac and I'm a PC.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
And I'm a PC. You know, we use a lot of the same kinds of programs. Yeah,
like this campaign Office, solidified the difference between a Mac and a PC in the consumer vocabulary. The irony is, of course, that this is also the year that Apple stopped using the PowerPC chip and switched to the Intel x86 architecture, in effect joining the PC clone family, where they've lived ever since. For Tech Laboratories, I'm Tech Adams, saying keep thinking, and thanks for watching. Hey guys, Tech here. Don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to Tech Laboratories by clicking on the links below for more weekly science and technology videos. Till next time.